Hi everyone. So this is part six of the end of 25 energy summary. And in this part, I want to talk about what some people are referring to as the whole New Age scene being part of a huge destruction campaign. Okay. So a lot of what we see in the so-called New Age, and I've never really been a fan of that word for the very fact that a lot of it, most of it is far from new. Most of it is made up of ancient wisdom, ancient tools, ancient teachings that have been around for who knows how long, probably at the end of the day, as long as souls have existed, it's been around somewhere. But, you know, just like, you know, let's look at an apple, for example, just like an apple has some bruises in it sometimes, so too this whole arena, just like any arena, has aspects of it that are, you know, a little bit, you know, don't belong there, you could say. So that ranges from, you know, unnecessary paraphernalia to, you know, perspectives that I think keep a lot of people as passive bystanders when Earth and humanity, especially at this time, could really use our active participation, could definitely use the active participation of conscious, aware souls. Where more often than not, it's very often the conscious aware souls that kind of have a little bit of a hands-off approach to active participation in, you know, in changing the paradigm of Earth and humanity. And while there's a lot to be said, and it's, you know, fantastic to use our energy to facilitate change, and that's just as important, it's also important to physically play a part in creating change. That doesn't mean you have to be out there and, you know, protesting or getting involved in anything you don't want to be involved in. But certainly our active participation, and, you know, that could just mean by, you know, being aware and conscious of your shopping habits. What are you buying? What are you purchasing? Where was it made? Is it good for your family, for the environment? Is it not? It's as simple as those little things, and that's where we all, you know, can definitely make a difference. And I think, you know, just as much as I'd say to someone who is more focused on the conscious non-physical aspects of our shift, I would say to them, you know, also incorporate putting that into practice, embodying it, you know, living and breathing it in whatever way, be it just your family, your home, or extending it into the community and greater world. So too, vice versa. I always, you know, want to say to the people who are, you know, doing things in a physical way to also be aware of doing it consciously, or to be also aware of their inner growth. It's both. And I think that's the exciting chapter that we're all heading into, where there is an integration going on between the physical and non-physical, between the conscious and the tangible. Integration, embodiment. Okay, so now let's just see what I want to say here. The other thing, you know, that is going on a lot is, you know, methods and rules that have been made up by people. You know, some are useful, others are just ridiculous. And channeled messages that range from really genuine, authentic wisdom that are, you know, fantastic to listen to. A lot of people have light bulb moments, and, you know, it profoundly affect people's lives in a really positive way. And then there's others that are a little bit what the. And again, it all comes back to, what do you resonate with? What makes you feel good? What makes you feel empowered? Versus what makes you feel a little bit off? And, you know, just use your discernment, and that's all any of us can do. Now, I want to get back to this New Age as a destruction, you know, thing that's, you know, part of the elite's grand plan, part of the Illuminati, blah, 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 blah. Look, at the end of the day, the powers that were did not create the content of what a lot of people refer to as the New Age, or some people refer to as the consciousness movement, or the wellness movement, or whatever you want to call it. They didn't create that. Have they in some sort of way manipulated it to their own means to keep people lost or passive or confused or inactive or running around in circles or with all this misinformation, disinformation, keeping everyone in the new age / conscious arena at loggerheads with each other, at finding, oh, my way's better, no, my way's better, those people are not doing the right thing, those people aren't doing the right thing. Meanwhile, anyone that gravitates to the consciousness or new age arena are probably some of the most powerful, you know, conscious creators on the planet because of your desire to be aware of how energy creates reality. And meanwhile, everyone's sort of kind of like a little bit distracted by, you know, the discrepancies between all the different, you know, ways that you can get involved in self-growth and self-awareness. So that's where, in a sense, it's kind of like, you know, I can't remember that saying where you throw something among the pigeons. It'll come to me later. But, you know, there's that saying, and it's, you know, sometimes I see a little bit of that going on where, you know, like, no one had to do anything really to create a whole New Age movement as a distraction campaign. But I can see how sometimes aspects of it have become a distraction to some people, and we need to just, you know, stop doing that and stop using it as an excuse for inaction and stop using it as a excuse to keep fighting amongst, you know, different people who are doing different things in different ways, and really unite, you know, unite within ourselves and unite with each other. And at the end of the day, we're all on the same page, we're all on the same team. No matter if you're doing something this way and, you know, your friends, you know, more wanting to go down the path of ancient wisdom, you know, from the pagans, and another friend's wanting to go down the route of Native Americans, and other friends wanting a more, you know, shamanistic, you know, Peruvian approach, and another friend's into crystals, you know. At the end of the day, anyone who gravitates to any of those things is just wanting to live a better life for themselves, usually for their family, for the community, for the world, okay? So, you know, it's at the end of the day, it's the entire movement, really, 99% of it is filled with powerful information and support, and a lot of people, a lot of teachers, a lot of facilitators, encouraging everybody to remember who they really are in an empowering way, okay? Where, you know, where we want to question things is if someone is wanting to either take your power or be your power for you, or suggest that without them you don't have any power. That is just ego BS. That's got nothing to do with what I would perceive to be an authentic soul-guided, high-consciousness way of teaching. And again, that's in any arena. You know, that's in business, that's in politics, that's in everything. You have the power. You know, don't let anyone tell you otherwise. Okay, a lot of people who gravitate, you know, to consciousness kind of material, self-help material, new age material, are often perceived by those outside those arenas as lost souls or weak. You know, you often read those sort of comments if you are reading a mainstream comment section, for example, when it comes to these sorts of topics. I think that it's the exact opposite, actually. I think far from being weak, far from being lost souls, you know, people who gravitate to sort of conscious self-help kind of material are among the most strong and powerful souls on the planet, who quite rightly feel lost because everything feels upside down. And it feels upside down because it is upside down. Because this reality, how we have lived it as a collective, how our systems and structures are, it's not how, you know, an awake, evolved society lives and functions. It's not how a society lives and functions when it comes to the society and the world that we know in ourselves we were here to help create. So of course, you know, people are going to feel a little bit lost and confused when they first start remembering who they are, or when they first start experiencing their awakening in whatever form. So if you have felt, or if someone has said to you, oh, only lost people or confused people or weak people or whatever buy into that crap, actually turn it around and think, well, hang on. No, it's there's a reason people are feeling lost and confused, because, yeah, the 3D world is kind of crappy and is kind of upside down. So people are just looking for something that can help them make sense of themselves and help them make sense of the world, really. So, you know, I know that a lot of people have been wanting and expecting a much more tangible, greater external visible signs of a shift, and are almost wanting to throw the baby out with the bathwater in terms of, well, where is a more, you know, tangible sign, and if there's not a more tangible sign, does this mean that the whole thing was a whole mind control psyops program that made us all sort of sit around waiting for 2012 while, you know, they kind of pillaged the world and took control? And, you know, again, I refer back to previous videos, previous blogs, where I have talked and talked and talked about this very specific aspect of this issue. And bottom line is, while it certainly, you know, the world hasn't changed to the degree and to the point collectively that we would all hope it would have by now, you cannot argue with the fact that it absolutely has, in terms of individuals awakening, collective awakening, in terms of shifts, in terms of truth seeking, in terms of truth coming out from under the carpet with what's going on with, as I mentioned before, whistleblowers coming out, the pedophile circles being exposed, more and more people gravitating toward, health and wellness. So it's happening. It just might be happening a bit slower than we might have hoped. Okay. Now, I also want to acknowledge that I myself regularly have talked about, and probably still will, talk about the incoming higher vibrational energies. And whenever there's a really huge wave coming, whenever there's been a massive solar flare, I've talked about that, I've written about that. And I just want to make something clear. I don't ever want that to be something that people hold on to, thinking that we have to somehow wait for these waves, or these waves are doing it for us, or we have to wait for all these waves to be over so that we can get on with our lives. The way that I see it is, the higher vibrational energies and waves, whenever I see them or perceive them, or the solar flares that were happening, they are there, I feel, to facilitate this process along, to help support this process along, just like an astrological influence, just strengthens something that's already in you, gives something a little bit of a push along, a kick along. It's our responsibility to use that energy. It's our responsibility to receive it, to anchor it, and when I say anchor it, I'm not meaning, doing some sort of non-physical thing there are people who do that and who close their eyes and meditate and anchor it in a vibrational way, and that's fantastic. That's their particular role or their particular thing that they're gravitating to. But by anchor it, my particular message and my particular sense is embodying it and utilizing these energies in your day-to-day life. When you get the tap on the shoulder that particular line of work is not for you anymore, step off, do something else. When you get the tap on the shoulder that you need to address something in your relationship, address it. When you get the tap on the shoulder that you need to start changing your lifestyle or what you eat, address it. That is, to me, how a lot of these high consciousness energies can be utilized in a way that we can start making changes in our day-to-day life. Now, just in a little bit of a kind of a point form, choose the path or paths that are right for you. You don't have to just choose one path. Just because you're into this doesn't mean you have to be not into that, So follow whatever feels right for you. You don't have to follow just one teacher. You don't have to follow any teacher. You are your own best teacher, really. All anyone is around you is, you know, like watching these videos, for example, I'm just kind of reminding you of what you already know. And a lot of people write and tell me that, and they say, wow, I already knew that, already got that same message, but just having someone else, you know, say it helps me validate my own feelings. Fantastic. Great. I think where the little dividing line is with power and handing over your power is, you know, external tools, external guides, external teachers are there to help you find your own power, not be your power for you, okay? So you don't have to follow any rules that make sense to you. God, I know that sounds like obvious and, you know, just almost silly to say, but God, you know, 20 plus years in this sort of arena, I've seen a lot. I've seen people follow people and follow people's rules that just to me are quite disempowering, and but they follow it because that person is in a position of authority. And just as much as I think now is the time where a lot of, you know, politicians and you know, priests and you know, media people are being held accountable for what they have participated in, what have they created, so too I think it's time to, you know, where a lot of people have been in trusted positions in the self-help industry also need to be held accountable, and also, you know, people need to open their eyes to someone just because they are a so-called guru, for example. You know, if they're asking you to do something that doesn't feel right, gosh, the stories I've heard, you know, with, you know, people, you know, saying, well, if you want to be initiated into this particular yoga practice or into this particular, you know, practice, you need to, you know, have sex with the teacher. Forget that. Like, you know, like that. And then people sometimes do because they start buying into the fact that, oh, I have to do this because this person meditated for 10 years, so he should know what he's talking about. No, your gut knows what you're talking about. So, you know, use external tools and teachers to help strengthen. This is such an important sentence. Use external tools and teachers to help strengthen your connection to your own self and soul, not replace that connection. Okay, I should have just said that one sentence really for this whole video. That's like the main crux of it all. Now, yeah, so I just want to like end this particular part with that Hopi saying, we are the ones that we've been waiting for. You know, where some people, you know, have been led down the garden path is believing that something or someone is coming along to help save us or to help clear this mess up or to, you know, shift the paradigm without us having to do anything. And I feel that, you know, we did come here to play an active part in shifting this planet, and any external things like influential higher dimensional energies are here to help facilitate that, but not do it for us, okay? At the end of the day, we're the ones that are here in physical bodies, in the physical, so we're the ones that are able to do it, and we have the power to do it, okay? So, yeah, it's only a distraction, new age / self-help / consciousness, da-da-da-da, only a distraction if we let it be a distraction, but if we use it as a really healthy, amazing, integrated part of our whole lives, you know, not have it be something separate to our lives, but an integrated part of our whole lives. We live it, we breathe it as much as we're living and breathing, you know, using it to inform our decisions of the best work for us, the best relationships for us, the best foods for us, the best lifestyles for us. Use that energy in your physical life to help inform your life in a conscious, aware way to live as healthy a life as possible, as powerful and productive a life as possible on every level, physical, mental, emotional, spiritual. That is how we use the self-help, new age, consciousness arena for the highest good, for our lives, for our world, and respect everyone's choices with the different paths of consciousness that they choose to participate in, as long as it's empowering them and feeling good for them. That's all. So join me on the next part, where I'm going to be talking about this false light topic also that's been around.